what is the road to dharma, the principle, and what constitutes dharma sankara, right? We have a very interesting question in from Ajay Piramal, referring to both these great books and what he draws from that.
What are the learnings that we can get to apply in the modern world from the Mahabharata and also from the Ramayana? And sometimes on first reading, it looks that there are several contradictions into what is said in Mahabharata and what is said in Ramayana. Can you just explain that to us?
You see, Ramayana and Mahabharata are both considered itihas. Now, itihas is conventionally translated as history, but it actually means it's a tense agnostic term, which means so it was, so it is, and so it will be. That means it is timeless.
Right.
One. Second is, let's look at Ramayana and the Mahabharata. They exist in two different contexts, so they cannot be seen as equals. And that's the mistake. The Western mind forces us to look at them as equal
books.
Why
don't the two communicate the same message
thing? Because you see, you have standardization, obsessed with standardization. But hamara kya swad anusar hai? So ek swad hai dwapar yug ka, ek swad hai treta yug ka. So one is for the treta yug, which is an earlier, more innocent age, and a later phase in the organization, which is darker, which is slightly more corrupt.
Okay.
Now, if I have to do the principle of dharma again, just to revise, you have got zero, plus, minus, zero, animal instinct.
Right.
This is exploitation. This is empathy.
Right.
Dharma is here, adharma is here.
Right.
Now let's do a simple 2x2 matrix to understand the Ramayana Mahabharata. So you have rules on one side.
Right.
Rules are followed, rules are not followed.
Okay.
Then we have the principle on the other side, dharma. Dharma is upheld, dharma is not upheld.
Right.
Now look at the Ramayana. In Ramayana, dharma is upheld and rules are upheld at the same time. So you have Ram. So rules and dharma are aligned. Everything is about the other. Everything is about the other. Everything is about the other.
Even at the cost of oneself.
Even at the cost of oneself.
Cruel almost always at the cost of oneself in the case of
Ram. Almost always.
Yes.
So it's misery in the forest, misery in the palace.
Got it.
His opposite is the great alpha male, which somehow people seem to like today, tells you about the times, is Ravan.
No dharma, no rules.
No rules, no dharma. Your wife is my wife.
Right.
And I'm an animal. Even my son dies, I will not let go of my little toy. My brothers die, I will not let go of my little toy. That's Ravan. Now look at this same thing. Rules are broken, bending and, you know, Krishna, always bending the rules, breaking the rules. But the principle is intact. It's always for the other.
Okay.
Now let's look at the most favorite character, Duryodhana. He never breaks the rule.
But he's constantly violating the principle.
He's constantly violating the principle. He is holding the letter of the law, never the spirit of the law.
Okay.
This is the spirit. This is the letter. This is the belief. This is the behavior. He's a pretender.
Where does Yudhishthira fit in all of this?
Yudhishthira is someone struggling to be Ram. He moves from here to here. This is the journey of Yudhishthira with the help of Krishna. You see, his honesty is about rules. He's not realizing it's not about rules, it's about principles.
Right.
Mahabharata is the story of focus on the principle. You say, so when a woman is being disrobed, everybody is discussing legal matters. Is it okay or not okay to disrobe her? I mean, grow up. This is Bhishma and Drona watching a woman being disrobed, and they are supposed to be very educated people, and they are not doing anything.
This brings me to a very interesting issue. You said that the Ramayana comes from an older age, an age of more innocence. The Mahabharata comes from a darker age.
Yes. It's a more matured organization. This is a very early phase organization. Just tasted success. Everything is right. Market is right. People
and the principles right. have just been created.
So it's exciting and new. People are not smart enough to subvert it yet.
Right. Here, in this
matured
stage, you've gone from principle to now a slightly more rule-focused organization.
The principles have been forgotten. Rules have become more important. So it's bureaucratic. Highly bureaucratic. Letter of the law. Spirit of the law is not there. Like any bureaucracy, all the rules are upheld, but people still don't have food. So the principle is forgotten. The woman is disrobed, but nobody's arrested.